Friends, this session is all about how to interface 8051 with some peripheral. For example, if you have to interface 8051 with the DC motor, you got a step of guidelines to follow. If you want to interface 8051 with a DC motor or stepper motor, you need to know how exactly you can proceed with it. It's not a straightforward connection, but you need to proceed with it in a way that's well predefined and there are certain guidelines to be followed. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm just going to show you how exactly we can interface 8051 with the stepper motor. That's it. It's a very simple exercise. Maybe not more than 8 minutes is what I require from you. Let's see how exactly we can interface 8051 with the stepper motor. Now, what is a stepper motor? How is it different from other motors is the normal question that everybody asks in the interview as well. Stepper motor and normal motor are almost the same. They rotate. That's it. So they actually convert electrical power to mechanical power, which means electrical to mechanical conversion is what is happening. But normal motor will rotate continuously, where stepper motor rotates in a fixed steps. For example, it rotates weights. So many steps will be needed to complete one circle. One circle is one rotation is what I'm talking about. It will not be straightforward one rotation. Here it will be multiple breaks in between, which I call as steps in between, to reach that one complete circle. And another thing that we need to remember is a motor is obviously built with stators and rotors. A rotor will have permanent magnets and stator will have coils. You can see that here. This is all coils. I'm talking about this is all coils, and they are all having 90 degree relationship to each other. This is 90 degree, this is 90 degree, this is 90, this is 90. And this is how they are fixed on. Now, these coils shall be activated one after another, and the way in which you activate it really determines that it can rotate clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. It's very simple. Now, the most important point that you need to remember is all these can be done as a sequence, and that sequence is what I have highlighted here in a table here. Coil 1, coil 2, coil 3, coil 4, and step. So if I put 1-1 to coil 2 and coil 3 first, it is step 1. Similarly, I have put 1-1 here for coil 3, coil 4, it is step 2. Coil 1 and coil 4, step 3. So likewise, I can just put it, and this is called as the step sequence, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, this is what I'm going to use very simply to just run my stepper motor. But for that, I need to first interface my stepper motor with something else. I mean, with my 8051, but it is not a straightforward thing. We need to know that how do we really interface it with 8051 through a mediator. There is a mediator available, and we need to know who that mediator is. Now, let us take this forward in 8421 format. 8421. So what will happen when you convert to hexadecimal? This is 06. This is 3, this is 8 plus 1, 9, this is 8 plus 4, 12, that is 0C. So we have got the sequence as 06, 03, 09, 0C. So the sequence is framed in hexadecimal. Now we got to interface it with our stepper motor, and it cannot be done directly because 8051 will not have enough driving ability. I am getting a ULN 2003 driver IC, which is used for this purpose. So ULN 2003, when interfaced with 8051, it can now drive the motor. It is not directly that 8051 is going to drive this. Instead, this one is connecting to ULN 2003, and ULN 2003 is connecting to motor, and the connections are shown below. This is 13 to 16, and I'm just connecting it to stepper motor. It could vary a bit here and there. Don't worry about it. When you set it up in the lab, in the hardware exercises, you'll be able to understand it pretty easily. And the port can be selected as any port as per your wish. There is no constraint here. Now, how do we run the code? It's very simple. I have already shown you the step sequence. So there is no rocket science there in the step sequence. Now, ORG0H stepper EQU P2. I'm using port P2. So I have made it equivalent to stepper. Now, move P2 comma 0CH. 0C is nothing but this one. So I am putting 0C here. Now A call delay. I am calling some delay here. It is just a value put in here, and I am decrementing the value so that there will be some delay. Now, what is the next value? 06. I am taking 06. So it goes this way now. I am taking 06 and I am loading it. I call delay. Now I am loading 03 and I'm calling delay. So that's it. The stepper motor will keep rotating now very clearly step after step. And the same can be performed using C program as well. But here I need to include the appropriate header files, and the procedure is all simple, all the same. The value is loaded and I got the delay called. So likewise, I'm loading it, and this can be clockwise or anti-clockwise. And most importantly, the delay which I use here is not a perfect delay. It is an arbitrary delay that I have given it myself. So it's for you to generate it in an appropriate step angle, you need to really calculate it and then give the delay values here. That's it. It's a very simple interfacing exercise. You guys can try it out in the lab, or if you have any simulator that really helps you out to even simulate this, that would be very useful. I hope this was useful. If you have any queries, you can probably type it in the comment. Thank you for following my channel. I'll get back to you with more inputs shortly. Thank you.